What is going on, guys? Welcome to Destiny. Now, guys, I hope you guys actually wanted to see my general builds for both my Hunter and my Warlock. So, in a nutshell, guys, that's exactly what this video is going to be. It's going to be showcasing my Warlock and Hunter. Hunter first, then Warlock. I am not sure if they'll be in different videos, but what you can expect in this video is me going over their guns, armor, and general build. Now, that word is kind of foreign to Destiny because of the sheer fact that your build is always changing. But not necessarily. You can build yourself in terms of gear to a certain thing. Intellect, discipline, or strength. Strength is your strength ability, and your discipline is your grenade, and then intellect is your super. So you can decide which one you want to favor, and then in that sense, you can kind of build your character to whatever thing you want to use most, I guess. Anyways, it'll be easier just to explain when we get into the actual thing. And in terms of weapons, tell you guys what kind of weapons are best suited for certain scenarios and why I keep them in my inventory. So yeah, let's do it. Alright guys, let's start with the Hunter first, and let's also talk about why builds aren't really a thing in the aspect of skill trees, because, well, in a nutshell, guys, skill trees are always changing based on the scenario. So say if you're, what kind of thing you should go for, agility, armor, or recovery, these all depend on the scenario in which you are doing. For instance, if you are just farming the patrol, you probably don't need too much armor because you're going to be fighting pretty low-level enemies depending on what your light stat is. And if you're doing the Nightfall, for instance, that every enemy is significantly more powerful than they've ever been, then yes, you're going to want a lot of armor. So that's the aspect that's always changing, and yeah. But with all that being said, I still have my preferences and what I always generally stick with in terms of grenades, jump abilities, and all the stuff, basically. We're gonna go through that. Alright, so let's go. Grenades first. Alright guys, so maybe not the most effective grenade, but it's definitely somewhat addicting. It's the Flex Grenade, and what that does, it's basically like a sticky grenade from Halo. It's like ridiculously fun just to beam a fallen right in the face and just have this ball land on its face and then just explode in utter chaos. And I do believe it does more damage if you're able to stick it to the target, which is just pretty all-around awesome to have, especially in the Nightfall, to be able to take down those elites super damn quick. Its blast radius is not that insane. Its damage, though, when it does stick to the target is, I think, insane. It's pretty good. I wouldn't say it's insane. No, it's pretty good. And the second one, guys, to put it shortly, I just don't really like it. Basically, when you throw it, a bunch of tiny grenades kind of just fall on the ground, and then if the enemy walks over them, it'll track it. I don't really like it. I feel like it's stupid. Anyways, but the third one, the Axion Bolt, is actually pretty insane. It has one exotic tied to it, which basically makes it so it chains further, and what it does is it basically chains an electric current to enemies, so it's basically a very high chance for you to get your said target. Like, with some grenades, you can throw it off a wall, it bank off, the enemy runs or backsteps two feet and he ends up getting out of the blast radius or whatever, or maybe you throw it and it fucks up or whatever. With the Accident Bolt, you throw it and you're most definitely going to get that target, so that's why it's really good for multiplayer and stuff like that, just so you're ensuring your fact that you're getting that damage. So that's pretty cool, but again, I just love that that's addicting, just to just unicorn somebody with a grenade. It's fucking awesome. Anyways, move on. Alright guys, let me see if I can actually speed this up just a tiny bit more. So for jumping, essentially, we have a higher jump, better control, or teleport, or blink, really. But anyways, I either go for blink or better control. The reason why I go for better control is because, I'm a jumper, guys, I'm not sure about you, but when I constantly play games like this, or Halo, or really anything that has a significant jump, I will constantly spam the jump because it's a way of dodging, and it's kind of just fun to stay in the air and shit. Anyways, so with better control, you're able to actually navigate through the enemy's damage. So when they're firing their electric bolts at you, for instance, Fallen or whatever, by using better control and just diving in certain directions, it will lunge you in different directions, whichever one you choose. And that will essentially help you dodge enemies really easily. And it's also good for just general movement. Just spamming the jump button will throw you forward twice as much as any other jump. And the reason why I would say better control is actually better than teleport is because there's no cooldown on it. You can literally use it infinitely. As soon as you hit the floor, you can bang it out again. But for teleport, that's not the case. For teleport, you actually can do it twice rapidly, and then you have to wait like 5 seconds, something like that. Enough to annoy you. So I usually go for teleport just because it's awesome, but better control is probably smarter. But I just like teleport. It's amazing. If you get really good at it, it's really good. Like, it's a different type of gameplay, especially multiplayer. If you get a teleport, it can really just drop on someone and fuck up their aim and all that good shit. So yeah, it's good for multiplayer, not so good for PvE. It's not the most effective thing in PvE. So anyways, Alright, and then we have our Super Arc Blade. Now, this is the one, honestly, out of everything that probably jumps around the most. It's just kind of fun to fuck around with all types of things. The first one is basically where you do it like a ballerina spin and you like release a bunch of currents around you and that can fuck up people in your vicinity, which is really good if you're actually planning on meleeing people. But you will get to the point where you can't do that anymore. Say the Nightfall and you're just getting your head kicked in, or you're fighting a boss and you're not able to get up in his face because he'll just monkey stomp you and just punch you in the face and kill you, or stomp the ground and you'll just die. Anyways, so you're gonna need the second one. The second one actually launches kind of like a current directly in front of you and it kind of stages and hovers to the ground and can function up in front of you. It has like the 5 feet, 6 feet, something like that, which is pretty good, especially for bosses. This is the one I kind of always have it on if I were to pick any that keeps it on that one. And then there's the third one, I think, is Vanish, which just literally just exactly what it sounds like. You just go invisible, and that's it. Which can actually be really beneficial towards a team, which is kind of weirdly enough, you wouldn't suspect the Blade Dancer to be kind of the support character, but compared to the Gunslinger, yes, he's very much that. He basically can go invisible, pick up your fallen guardians, and all that kind of shit, or just be a troll and go invisible and just backstab all the fallen and dark creatures? I don't know. What are they called? Ah, fuck it, doesn't really matter, we're killing them anyway. Bye. Alright guys, I forgot this was more my preferences. I'm in the mindset of explaining everything right now, so I should really hold off on that and just tell you guys what I use. So we got the best melee augment, I personally think, in the game. Fling Strike. Now, this alone isn't the greatest, honestly, about the melee thing. What it does, basically, is it just teleports you an extra 2 to 3 feet, but that's kind of being generous. It sometimes doesn't lock on properly, and that's a whole thing. Like, I'll aim at an enemy, try to do a melee, and yeah, you run the risk of basically just meleeing the air and look like an idiot, so that's just the shitty thing, I guess. Anyways, but its special augment, though, its third one in particular, is what makes it fucking amazing. Basically, just landing a hit with your, Blink Strike will turn you invisible. This takes you completely out of combat, and that can be so amazing, especially if you're playing with, like a strike or whatever. You see when your teammates go down, you just quickly stab someone in the face, and then just run over to them, pick them up, you got, like, 100% safety, it's fantastic. And guys, this kind of brings me to my next point, and that is my favorite thing about the Blade Dancer is that he can go invisible. He has skills such as just standing still, crouched. You immediately go invisible after, like, 2 seconds, just to make sure it's not, you know, overpower. And it can actually increase that invisibility chain for, like, I think it's 10 seconds, which is more than enough, considering you have two ways to become invisible, just sitting on your ass and then also stabbing any enemy. It's super easy to go invisible. And that's why I love the Blade Dancers, because I feel like he's built for Lone Wolf players, because, well, being invisible, you can literally just run across every asshole of an enemy and just get shit done, like, extremely quickly, which is great, especially for strikes or whatever. Or if you have to complete a strike or a story mission, you can literally just run past all the enemies, get to the one you gotta kill him, be done with it, fucking golden, it's amazing. Anyways, and in the kind of special Blade Dancer augments, guys, I either go for Shadow Jack, which increases your ability to basically be invisible longer. Like I said, it gives you 10 seconds of invisibility, which is, normally I think you only have 5, which gives you another 5, which is fucking great. Anyways, or I go to Flat Footed, which basically just increases your speed. I like to dodge, bob and weave, and all that kind of stuff, which just kind of helps in Destiny, because weirdly enough, you can literally dodge, which is awesome. And like Call of Duty or whatever, you can't dodge. But Destiny, you can, which is badass to me. Anyways, so yeah, I usually go to flat footed just because it gives you a little more movement speed. I like being fast. I like being at the front of the line, I guess. Anyways, so yeah, guys, that's all I'm going to talk about for our character. Whew, that was a lot of info. I tried to make it quick, just kind of telling you guys my general assumptions and why I choose the things I choose. Let's talk about the most important thing, which actually can make up a build, which is the gear. Not the weapons, the gear. Alright guys, so let's start with Mask of the Third Man. Now this is an exotic, and this is the exotic that I choose, honestly, in my experience and seeing all of the exotics in the game. The masks in general seem to be the kind of where it's at for exotics, because it holds the most perks, it seems to give you the biggest buff in terms of stats, and just, yeah. So guys, if you play Blade Dancer, this helmet is made specifically for you and your arc abilities. Now, it basically is melee. That, since you're a Blade Dancer, it's going to focus on your arc blade. So what that does basically is it decreases the cooldown for every time you use arc blade. So every time you throw a knife made of lightning in the air, it kind of loses its touch. But with this mask on, it helps degrade that highly. So basically, you barely even notice you're wasting energy, basically. Every time you hit something with your knife or even swing it, I think, it does take away a chunk of your super. But with this mask on, you barely even notice a difference, and ah, yeah, it's super cool. It looks fucking crazy as shit as well. You look like a fucking cyclops. Kind of, sort of. You look like a hive, honestly. You look like a hive. But cool shit, love it to tears, looks badass, and my fucking eyes glow. What else could I want? But like I said, going with the kind of arc blade thing, our super, it will give us a mass amount of intellect, and I mean a mass amount of intellect. I think it gives us like a 91, which is insane. That's like a lot of intellect, which makes us be able to use our arc blade to an insane degree. Which is awesome. Now guys, probably should have opened with this, but when it comes to gear and like your chest piece, your arm piece, and your leg piece, you have to make a choice. You can either go with stats or special perks. Now special perks meaning hold more ammo for an assault rifle or reload so-and-so weapon faster. You can either choose those or you can choose the status effects that it gives you. By that I mean how much intellect it gives you, which decreases your super ability, how much discipline it gives you, which decreases your grenade cooldown. All those things, you have to choose. Very rarely will you get both sides of the coin. You know, you won't get both sides of the spectrum, you'll get either one or the other. Like, for instance, I love hand cannons to tears, but for life of me, I couldn't find a chest piece that gave me intellect, and reloaded hand cannons faster. I just couldn't get it, so I said, fuck it, let's just have a massive amount of intellect. And I just said, whatever, I can deal with the hand cannon reload speed, whatever. So, you have to make that choice. And guys, for perks, for instance, for my, my hunter, honestly, I lucked out and I got exactly what I needed for my hunter, all in one exotic mask, which my hunter has for his mask is a faster melee speed, which is my favorite perk to have. And on top of that, it also allows me to, whenever I kill an enemy of the darkness, which is basically, it's a PvE perk and I love it. Basically, whenever we kill a dark or enemy, really, other than a guardian, we get our super back a lot quicker. We get a lot more cooldown towards our super, which is just amazing. Again, going back into the fact that blade dancing for days. So yeah, guys, that's all I really wanted to talk about, at least in terms of my armor and gear. These stats is what I chose, so I'm showing you guys the stats. Essentially, I got a lot of intelligence, so again, let's play dance for days. And my strength is not that great. Funnily enough, guys, I actually had a melee build. Like, that's where I put all my points into. I just wanted to have a lot of melee regen for the sheer fact that that one perk, being able to stab someone and going invisible, was just too damn awesome. But then again, if you play a lot of end game and get into the raid or like the nightfall, where there's like a lot of burns on there that can fuck with you, like, just the melee augment, so if I get close, I die. That's why I said, it's not that useful just in that scenario, so might as well just go with a lot of intelligence, because that way I can go invisible if I want, I can do mass damage at a distance, I can do mass damage up close, all of that awesome shit. So I said, screw it, let's just go with intellect, since it kind of covers all bases. And yeah, guys, that's all I'm going to talk about for the special augments to your armor and stuff like that. I'm not going to talk about the perks too much, because honestly, again, I chose stats over perks. Perks being, in my armor at least, are not stuff I really use, like pulse rifle reloads, or killing a guy with a grenade gets you a fucking more cooldown for your melee. You know, none of that really matters to me, although it should, but I just don't notice it. I don't really, yeah, whatever. Moving on to guns, which is kind of the bread to the butter anyways. Alright guys, so basically, like I said guys, I'm in love with hand cannons, as is majority of the people on Destiny, because they are hella powerful, and they also have some of the coolest effects in guns in general for exotics. Now, I'm gonna go through the exotics that I use for hand cannons, the three that I mostly use. Now, the exotic hand cannons that I use is the Thorn, just because it got that buff, and now it is worthy to be an exotic, and it is pretty damn badass. Although it is not the best hand cannon, because it doesn't have the best exotic perk. Its exotic perk is basically that it causes a damage over time effect, which is nice, but the damage over time effect is not that useful, and honestly, I'm not gonna wait for something to die. I'm gonna shoot it in the face till it dies. I'm not gonna sit there and be like, shooting once, oh, I almost got him. I don't want that to happen. So I just say, fuck it, let's just shoot until the clip's gone. So I just use it kind of as a normal exotic gun, which is, again, it's pretty all-around good, like reload speed, fire rate, clip size, all that kind of stuff is just a generally good hand cannon, so I just use it as a hand cannon. The last word, though, is also a pretty good hand cannon. It is just, it looks amazing for one, and it's also just a pretty unique and kind of awesome gun in general. I kind of just fell in love with it. I loved it at first, and then I kind of just was like, okay, I'm done. I don't know why. But I still do keep it in my inventory, just because it's pretty cool. So yeah, that's what comes down to for hand cannons. If I ever do get the Hawk Moon, which people say is the best gun in the game, and I'd have to agree with them, it looks pretty badass, I will probably add that to my collection and worship it and love it forever and be so fucking happy if I could just see it in my inventory every day, and I'd be like, oh my god, guess what, Fate and RNG Jesus, suck my dick. Enough said. And awesomely enough, guys, I actually just got a ton of exotic assault rifles, and I cannot wait to use them and leveling them up and see how much of a kick they use. I hear that's the other thing that people use in the community is like either it's hand cannons or assault rifles. So I want to test out what the assault rifles are. And yeah, I might change that. But guys, similar to the armor, but you know, even more so with the guns, it's based on preference, which is kind of obvious. But yeah, I just thought I'd tell you guys about my hand cannons, but I will tell you guys about the three weapons that I kind of always have on hand, just because with the nightfalls and with the burn effects and with just general amazing effectiveness, I tend to always have them in my inventory. One is the Icebreaker, which is honestly one of the first weapons, exotics that I ever actually got, which is where I think my luck actually went when I first played Destiny. Then it just never happened again until now, which is awesome because I got a lot of assault rifles that are exotics, which I'm super happy about. Anyways. So, the Icebreaker, it just atomizes things, and it also regens ammo. It's like the picture-perfect best friend for a solo player, so that's why I have that on hand. It's really good for nightfall, especially if it also has a solar burn, because it does solar damage. So it absolutely atomizes shit with that solar burn on, but even without it, it still does a pretty good crit damage, and it also regenerates ammo. So again, fucking yes. Anyways, the second one is actually from the Dark Below. It is actually Murmur. It's a legendary fusion rifle that can help just atomize everything, even elites. If you're able to actually max out its damage, it's able to literally atomize elites in the nightfall. It's pretty insane. And on top of that, it can be both solar and arc, so it really is meant for people that are doing the nightfall and stuff like that. Not really just specifically meant for them, but it just helps with that. And then the other weapon that I always have is a heavy machine gun, just because sometimes the nightfall can have a burn effect. Now, with an assault rifle that has that burn effect on it, it's a beast. Like, literally just 1,000 damage per shot. Like, I'm not sure if it's that much, but it's pretty insane, and that's why I always keep a heavy machine gun on hand, especially, like, I have one of every element, just because, again, it wrecks stuff in the nightfall, like, to an insane degree. So, anyways, guys, that's where I'm gonna leave it. I told you guys everything that I kind of use. Again, I usually use hand cannons, preferably the Thorn, and if I can get it, the Hawk Moon. And for my secondaries, I usually use, for exotics wise, I use the Icebreaker or Murmur if I just want to use a legendary. For my other ones, I don't have any exotic heavies, so I usually just use a heavy machine gun that is legendary, which is just more than enough work. But anyways, guys, yeah, that was the video for my Hunter, Blade Dancer-centric, and kind of telling you guys what I use and why my build, essentially, which is pretty much centered towards, intelligence. I probably made this longer than I probably should have, but, what she said? Does that make sense? I'm bad at those. I'm really horrible at those. Anyways, guys, nevertheless, thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I will do my best to get the Warlock one out as soon as I possibly can. I'm surprised how long this one took. How draining it was. My voice hurts like hell right now. I know you guys probably can't tell, but it really does. Anyways, guys, nevertheless, thank you guys so much for watching, as always, and later, guys. Also, thank you to the people that suggested this, because I got a video out of it. So, thank you for asking me to do this, so that I could give this to you guys and shit. So, anyways, bye!